Game 2 of this three-game series between the Miami Marlins and the East-leading Philadelphia Phillies. Hi again, folks. Welcome back to Phillies Baseball here on the show. Alongside me are Major League veterans Steve Lyons and Eric Karros. And, Steve, let's talk about the two starters that take the baseball here tonight.
Yeah, and you've got a couple of guys here that aren't afraid to challenge you at the plate. They're not afraid to let you put the ball in play and let their fielders make the plays behind them. That should make for a pretty good matchup.
Christian Yelich makes his way to the plate now as we're just about set for baseball this evening.
Left fielder, Christian Yelich.
Underway this evening as the first pitch is taken for strike one as we get started right on time at 7.05 p.m. These Phillies, Eric Karros, as they enter play here tonight, they've been in a nice little groove of winning three of their last four games.
It's always important to play good baseball in front of the home crowd, and they were fortunate to get this series off on the right foot in game one. They'll hope to continue their winning ways here in game number two.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And the pitch. Nip the corner. Two and two. Now the pitch. Now a foul tip straight into the catcher's glove, and he's able to hang on to record the first out of the inning. A look here at the scouting report as we'll show you what to expect moving forward from the 30-year-old right-hander. Martin Prado will stand in as he'll enter play fourth in the National League batting race. That tails back over, strike one. There are the batting leaders in the National League, of which we spoke just a moment ago. And this will be fouled away. The 0-2 home from Billingsley. Now here's a ball hit sharply toward the right side. And oh, a bad hop there as it's over his head at first.
And you can tell that out there on the mound, he's definitely thinking about back-to-back strikeouts here to start off this ballgame. He gets it to two strikes on the number two hitter, but then he can't come up with that put-away pitch, and he winds up serving up a one-out single.
Giancarlo Stanton will stand in now. Certainly a dangerous hitter as he ranks number two in the National League in home runs. Curveball looked at here for strike one. And there is the full list of home run leaders we alluded to a moment ago. He's ready now, the pitch. Another curveball here, but this misses in tight. It's a ball and a strike.
Well, that's a pretty good spot to try and lock him up inside, but you know, he can turn on that location if that's out over the plate.
And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's one and two.
Yeah, the best way to neutralize this guy's power, just keep putting pitches right there.
Here's Billingsley's one and two. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. A leap there by Revere, but he comes up empty as that one is gone. A long two-run homer off the bat of Giancarlo Stanton. Number 25 for him on the year. And the Marlins have taken a 2-0 lead.
Wow, he has proven to be a real nuisance in the first two games of this series. A home run in last night's ball game, and now another one here.
Marcell Ozuna will stand in now, and obviously one to be careful with, as you see there, currently leading the senior circuit in long balls. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0.
Well, this is a spot where it helps to have a two-seam fastball like that so you can work in on the right-handed hitters.
Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way, and he's got himself a base hit.
As we look at that again, you know, this is not a bad pitch by any stretch. If he throws this pitch 10 times, I bet he gets him out 9 of them. But here you just have to tip your cap to the guy at the plate.
Michael Morse will get his first shot down, and he's seen that average climb a bit here recently thanks to what he's done over the course of these last five ball games. The 1-0 pitch. Here's a breaking ball that falls in there for a strike to even things at 1-1.
So tough to hang in there on that pitch, but you got to do it. You can't give up that inside corner, or this guy will eat you alive.
Revere is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Whoa, and as a pitcher, you'll hold your breath anytime a ball's hit in the air at this place. But luckily, he got under this ball a little bit too much, and that runner has to retreat back to first base.
Jared Saltalamacchia will get his first shot here. Two hits in five trips a night ago. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing and one. And that's lifted in the air out toward left. And Brown will put this one away, and that ends the inning. But two in the inning for the Marlins, thanks to the two-run home run. On to the bottom of the first. It's now 2-0 Miami. Starting lineup for the Phillies is there on your screen. Ben Revere will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first. Fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. EK, you take a look at our visitors as they enter play here this evening. They've been in a serious tailspin of late, winning just once in their previous 10 games.
And you know, the little things have been a recurring theme on these telecasts for years now, but when you're in a losing streak like this, no matter how minor it is, it always seems like the little things are going the other team's way. That has certainly been the case these last few games.
Chase Utley will stand in, and he was a big part of the win last night as he contributed three hits to his guy's effort. Now here's a swing and another chance out there at second. Throw to first, and Utley's retired, two gone.
Batting third, right fielder.
Brandon Jordan will stand in, currently eighth in the National League in hitting to enter play. Here it comes. This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Now the pitch. Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch, and it's 0-2. You got to figure that that man right there would be more than happy to see this guy at the plate taking his swings with two out and nobody on all night long.
So would the guy on the mound.
Nothing across here this half. We'll move to inning number two here in Philadelphia. The Marlins lead it 2-0. Donovan Solano will get his first opportunity now. And as you see there, he's in need of something to go his way because he's been ice cold these past eight ball games. Too high that time with the inning's first pitch. It's ball one. And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time. And it's 2-0 now.
You can bet he's a little rattled still from that first inning. He gave up a lot of solid contact that first time through the lineup.
And he gets this fastball over, back to 3-1 now.
And at the plate, he might have been told, look, you're taken until you get a strike. Not a bad idea.
Swing and a ball hit foul as this will find the seats in right. Full count pitch on its way. Pitch in the dirt, swung on and missed for strike three as they'll need to throw to first here. Throw on to first is in time to get him, so that'll go down as a strikeout and a 2-3 putout for out number one.
Yeah, a nice job behind the plate. He wants it low, so he's got a good idea that this ball might be in the dirt, so he's able to smother it and then make the strong throw to first.
Here's Echeverria now. Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one.
Yeah, those are the ones you like to start in that bat, especially your first time up.
I agree. Give me a nice, easy one in the dirt that I can take so I can really get ahead in that count early.
There's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. Here comes the 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now. One out, nobody on. A late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. And a sliding attempt at first, but this sneaks by him, a base hit.
Yeah, that's definitely a hit all the way, but let's check out the attempt here at first base. I think maybe if he stretches out, he could have knocked this ball down, but instead, you see that ball get on him just a little too quickly there as he gives it the sliding effort, but I think that ball was headed for right field all the way.
In now, Jose Fernandez. And they elect to have the pitcher bunt with one gone as he puts this one down. And the throw will come to Utley covering the bag as the sacrifice works that time. Christian Yelich will dig in for a second time, a strikeout victim opening up the ballgame. And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
He wanted to go after that one, but that's a good eye to just...
Sorry to interrupt, but the play has been made for the third out. Inning over. One left for Miami. They're up 2-0. Michael Franco will stand in now. He homered in the ballgame last night. Now here's the first pitch. This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. And now a pitch on the way. Fouled straight back. Here comes Fernandez, 0-2. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
On 0-2, if that's a curveball, a changeup, a sinker, then maybe you get a guy to chase. But it's much easier to lay off a pitch down there when it's a straight fastball.
Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down.
Well, it's really not too hard to figure out what the game plan is on a guy like this. You cannot give him anything up around the belt that he can drive. So you're going to see that all four pitches are either mid-thigh or below, and that's right about where you're going to want to be pitching against a guy like this.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre. Hit hard to short. Throw to first will be in time to retire Beltre, and there's out number two. Salvador Perez will get his first chance now, trying to get something started with two away here in the bottom of the second. Now here's the first pitch. Fastball in there for a called strike.
You know, it's so important with guys like this to get ahead with strike one. Put them behind in the count and on their back foot right away.
Now here's a slow grounder to the left side. Throw to first will get him easily and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. They're still down. It's 2-0. Martin Prado is ready to go here as we begin the third.
Third baseman, Martin Prado.
Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. Now here it comes. Now a little pop-up off toward the first base side. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Billingsley ready. Another 0-2. Now a little dribbler up the line to first. But this will wind up foul, still 0-2. Here's another 0-2. The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now.
Well, he might have just said, look, you're going to have to take this one because you ain't fouling that one off.
And this is hit well towards the hole. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Well, that's a nice job right there to readjust to that curveball. I don't know if he was sitting on it or what, but he certainly hit it hard. Unfortunately for him, right at someone.
Giancarlo Stanton will try things again. He hit that two-run homer his first time. First pitch on the way. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. Now here's the pitch. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. The pitch. And they'll come inside with this one, but the result's the same. It's to 2-1 now. Still no fastballs in the at-bat. It's been all off speed.
That's definitely by design. He's such a good fastball hitter. You don't want to give in to his strength.
Called strike two, and now it's full 3-2.
But this is the thing that's so impressive about this guy. He'll show you that good breaking ball, but then he'll run that fastball up the ladder at 92, 93.
Once again, a 3-2. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. Throw to first will take care of him, and it's a good start to the inning for Billingsley. Two away. Marcell Ozuna will dig in. He singled his first time around. And there's the fastball Billingsley has that we've heard so much about. Good for strike one. And the pitch. A lot of movement that time. It's 0-2.
And I'll tell you, being in a two-strike hole is not the spot you want to be in against a guy like this.
Now he drops a changeup on him. Strike three called, and a great pitch there to retire the side. So a fairly routine inning that time for Chad Billingsley. His club needs to get him some runs, however. It's 2-0. Dominic Brown will come forward to begin the inning. 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
They're still searching for a base runner. It's been 6 up, 6 down to start the game.
Now a swing by Brown as this ball is drilled out to deep right field. Stanton is back for a look, but this will sail over the wall for a home run. A solo home run for Dominic Brown. Number 13 for him on the year. And the Phillies have cut the lead in half. It's now a 2-1 game.
Just their first hit of the night, but what a hit it was. He squares up on this thing perfectly and just drives it over the wall. That had some serious hang time to it.
Here's big Ryan Howard now. And there's a swing and a miss at an off-speed pitch to start him out. Nothing in one. He may not throw a ton of changeups here tonight, but he's got a good one when he needs it.
And I think he will need it because this is a good fastball hitting team. Most teams are. So the more you can keep these guys guessing off balance, the better.
Base is empty here with nobody out. Here comes Fernandez, 0-2. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. On to first, and the Howard shift pays off there. One away. After tonight, these two teams right back at it again on Sunday as you get a look at our upcoming schedule that takes us into next week. Chad Billingsley will dig in with one in and one away. Here's the first offering. Now a ball hit fouled off to the right and up into the crowd. Bases are empty, one man out. Pitch on the way. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Here's the pitch. Lifted down the line in right and back out of play. Count holds it 0-2. Here comes another 0-2. A little bit off the outside. It's 1-2.
Yeah, after that last swing, I would have thought they'd go right back in, but that's actually not a bad location because I doubt he was looking for something else.
Now a swing and a sharp ground ball to third. On to first, and there are two down. Ben Revere will dig in again. He grounded out to start the home first. First pitch coming. Now a swing and a fly ball. Yelich has to retreat to the track, but he has it to retire the side. I have to imagine there's a full moon tonight, judging by this bunch. We're back with more on this Saturday night after this. Michael Morse will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
First baseman.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. Looked like a breaking ball there, but it missed badly. 2-0.
And this is what you got to do up there, Steve. You got to wait him out.
Yeah, and if you can lay off the off-speed stuff, that's when you're going to get your fastball to hit.
And, oh, he thought that was ball four, but it's called a strike. 3-1 now.
That's a borderline strike right there. And I think that he had one step out of the batter's box headed towards first already.
3-2, here it is. Now a ball hit high in the air, deep down the line in left, hooking just a little. And that's off the left field foul pole, a home run. So a solo shot down the line in left. Number 18 for him on the campaign, and it gives the Marlins a 3-1 lead.
Oh, and you could hear the groans from here, emanating from both the stands and the pitcher's mound. This was actually much, much closer than I thought it was going to be. I thought it would be fair easy. But you see it clank right off the foul pole, and that is a home run.
The catcher, Jared Saltalamacchia, is in now. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing and one.
Boy, he goes right back to that same pitch that he just gave up a home run on. Put it in another dangerous location, too. Lucky he got away with that one.
The 0-2 home from Billingsley. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down. So with one away, let's punch up the graphic and show you the pitch speed comparison for the two starters here in the fourth inning. And whoa, look at that for a top speed. 98 miles an hour. That man is flat dealing. Donovan Solano is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one.
He did not like that one bit. Now, it's one thing to work in with the hard stuff, but don't do it around the dome.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Now a swing as he hits this one into the air. But this will be foul off to the right, out of play. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
And he's got a little bit of work to do now to avoid that first walk.
Now a swing and a high fly ball, and this one has some carry on it to deep right field. Jordan back in plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone.
Boy, these are the kind of days where even I want to grab a bat. Everybody on that offense is hitting the ball hard somewhere.
Adani Echevarria will stand in. A base hit his first time around. Here's a curveball that runs outside. It's ball one. The next pitch. And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now.
And I think with no one on base, you know, this is a guy you need to come after. I certainly wouldn't be afraid to give him a fastball here.
That one's in there, 3-1. Three runs, five hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. Fastball in there, 3-2.
Yeah, and he's trying to make sure that he doesn't allow that first walk. He's worked it back to full count now after being behind in the count.
I'll hold that thought as the play is made out there for out number three, and the side is retired. One for the Marlins on the solo shot. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 3-1 Miami. Back alongside Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, Matt Vasgersian, and Chase Utley getting set to start things out here in the Phillies' half of the inning. First offering on the way. first pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. Here it comes. Swing and a miss as the count goes to 0-2 on Utley.
Well, as we've seen so far, this isn't a team that's going to wait around too long to feel a pitcher out. They're an aggressive team all the way from top to bottom. And if that first pitch is anywhere close, most of these guys are going to take a hack at it.
Here comes a 1-2. Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two.
It's just so hard to lay off that slow changeup. He just did break that swing off in time.
Sets the 2-2 pitch. And this is swung on and missed by Utley as he's retired for out number one.
Well, after getting ahead here 0-2, you know, he nibbles for a couple pitches and then finally just says, all right, I'm through with this. So he goes back to the fastball, just blows it right by him.
Picking on the first pitch as this is on the ground towards short. Throw gets him, two down.
You know, there's no such thing as a routine grounder with this guy. If you take your time, he's going to be safe. He'll beat it out. So that's a nice job of getting rid of it quickly and getting him at first base.
Oh, this is hit hard towards second. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And he's going to make it there. Barely, as he's into second base with a double.
Well, he's got a lot of people excited around here. Not only does this guy have a chance to be an everyday player, he has a chance to be an impact player for years to come. And the early results, they look good as he hammered that one for a solid double.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre. As he'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. And that is through into center field, a base hit. And that'll break the run from second as the lead shrinks to one at 3-2 now.
Well, it looked like this inning was just about in the books, but then you get the two-out double to put the man in scoring position. Next hitter follows that up with a base hit here and makes something out of the inning after all.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Phillies get a couple of hits here, and it leads to one on the scoreboard. On to the top of inning number five we go. It's the Marlins 3 and the Phillies 2.
Leading off for Miami, the pitcher,
Jose Fernandez, stands in as he checks his swing here for strike one. Now a swing, and the barrel of the bat breaks in two that time. No problem here, one away. Christian Yelich will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. And a high strike to begin the at-bat, it's 0-1.
You can tell here, in his mind, he's thinking, quick inning. He's not even trying to set guys up. He's coming right after them.
Fifth inning of play here in a 3-2 ball game. Now a swing and a ground ball, but this will be a foul ball, and it's still 0-2. On the ground to third. Up with it is Beltre. And a throw over to Howard, and that's the second out. Martin Prado will dig in here. 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. Here's a curveball that runs outside. It's ball one. Now here's the pitch. Outside with the breaking pitch, and he falls behind at 2-0. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he finds the black here with a curveball, 2-1. Pretty clear the plan is to keep everything away.
And that's smart for most guys, but you've got to know your scouting report because this is a guy that can cover the outside part of the plate.
2-2 pitch on the way. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. They're up 3-2. Dominic Brown will start things out for the Phillies with the dangerous Ryan Howard waiting on deck. And here's the first pitch. Not even close on that swing. No balls and a strike. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
Here comes Fernandez, 0-2. In under the hands with a fastball, it's 1-2.
I'll give him this. He's not intimidated up there. That was inside. Close to triple digits. Didn't even flinch.
1-2 pitch is swung on and lifted in the air out to center field. Ozuna is under this one, and he's got it for the first out.
This crowd oohs and ahs every time this guy hits a fly ball, but he didn't get all of that one, and it's pretty much a can of corn.
Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. Ryan Howard will stand in for the second time as he watches one miss low. It's a ball and no strikes. Now Howard waits on the 1-0. A little late that time as he swings and misses for strike one. Fernandez readying the 1-1. Ooh, he saws him off with that one. But foul.
Wow, just a jam sandwich right there. And all he's holding is about half of his bat. Those look like the kind of bats I used to swing with.
Oh, and you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
Yeah, not a real good job of pitch recognition there. I mean, this ball was going to be in on his hands to begin with. I don't know quite what he saw that made him want to swing at that thing, but it just completely locked him up there.
Stepping in now, Chad Billingsley. As he will swing at the first pitch and send a ground ball out to short. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. Phillies down in order. Still a 3-2 ball game. Giancarlo Stanton will stand in here, but before he does, let's take you back to the very first inning. This was a two-run home run right out of the gate that really got these guys off to a fast start. First pitch coming. High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one. Now the pitch. No offer at the curveball either. It's 2-0. Now the pitch. Swing and a ball pulled foul into the lower level and left. Here it comes, 2-1. And this is fouled back and out of play. Here he comes on 2-2. Swing and he takes this the other way to right. Jordan is there to put it away for out number one.
He's been able to get outs when he needs it with that curveball. And there you see what his pitch breakdown has been so far.
Marcell Ozuna will stand in now. He's singled and struck out in two trips. First pitch coming. First offering to him stays upstairs. It's a ball and no strikes.
Yeah, that's a good spot to miss against a guy like this. He loves that pitch up in the zone. Most power hitters do, so that's not a bad idea to give him one above the letters.
That's on the corner to put him behind now. 1-2.
I tell you, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
Got him looking with the fastball as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone.
Well, as we take a look at the pitches by inning, that last one puts him at 91. So stamina will start to become a real factor here the further he goes along.
First pitch to him. Michael Morse stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. And a good heater as he just watches this baby, a ball and a strike.
Yeah, a little surprising he didn't offer at that one. That was a dangerous spot for a good fastball hitter.
Oh, and this one is hit a ton out to center. Racing back the center fielder. But he won't have a shot at this one. It's high off the wall. Around second. He'll try for third. And he'll make it into third here with a two-out triple.
Well, he wasn't too far away from home run number two in the ball game. This thing is tagged pretty good, and you'll see it's going to hit off the wall out there, and in the end, he'll make it all the way up to third. Have a game.
Some action in the Phillies' bullpen as a right-hander begins to crank it up out there. Here's a swing and a ground ball. This is foul for the first strike. 3-2's our score here in inning number six. Here's a ground ball now toward the hole, and he is going to come through here with two away. It's a base hit. And the run will score from third to make this a 4-2 game.
Now batting.
Donovan Solano will try and keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. Ball one. Pause, now the pitch. Perhaps a little low there. It's 2-0. You'd have to think a walk here would hasten his exit from the ballgame.
Yeah, he can't let that happen. In a close game like this, gotta make him put it in play.
Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1. From the stretch. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away. Adani Echevarria is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0.
And for all the pitches he's thrown, only one walk so far. That's a little bit surprising.
Ready now on 1-1. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. Jordan will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Marlins get one here on a couple of hits. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. Miami's out in front, 4-2. Ben Revere will stand in to lead things off as the top of this batting order really hasn't been much of a factor so far.
Yeah, between the top three guys in this lineup, no hits between them. And you got to figure you're not going to win too many games when that's the case.
And now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action as a lefty and a right-hander start to get loose.
One of the first times tonight that they've had their leadoff man on base. Now they've got to find a way to build on it if they want to get back in this thing.
Chase Utley will step in now representing the potential tying run.
Keep in mind, he is the team leader in home runs, so if anyone's got a shot of getting one out of here, it's him.
Here's the first offering. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. And you figure now this would be a spot where that man might try to take second base.
And it wouldn't be a bad idea to hold the ball a little longer out there on the mound. Really bury your times to the plate. You can't be predictable out there or he'll take advantage.
And he won't even try it at second as he flips to the pitcher covering to get the shooter out.
You can't underestimate how important a start this is when your team's on a losing streak. He has been phenomenal. And it's all thanks to him that they've got a good shot at ending this thing.
Here's the first pitch to him. Brandon Jordan is at the plate as he watches ball one.
Well, you know, if there's anybody in this lineup capable of getting a rally started, this is the guy right here.
Here comes the 1-0. Aiming for that outside corner, but just missing. 2-0. Looks like he's not going to see anything here.
Yeah, I don't think so either. They gave him two shots to see if he'd go out of the zone to try to chase, and after that, I'm thinking they should just put him on.
Outside, 3-0 now. Green light here on 3-0.
Yeah, I want my run producer swinging the bat. It's my number seven hitter? Probably not.
And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will land foul, shy of the wall. Now the 3-1 pitch. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. Here's the 3-2 pitch. hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd foul. We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. Here's the full count offering. Swing and a liner toward right center. Base hit. Around third and being waved on hold. And the run is in the score from second as they cut it to one at 4-3 now.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see. And he was right on that one.
Into the box now, Michael Franco, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. Seemed to quicken his delivery to the plate on that last pitch.
Well, you got to remember, the slide step does two things for you. It gets the catcher the ball quicker so he can throw a guy out.
Ah, and meanwhile, this pitch gets away from him. And not what they were hoping for, as that moves the possible tying run into scoring position. Good eye. Here's the 1-1. On a big swing, and he crushes this ball deep. My goodness, a long home run. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. Number 13 for him on the year, as they will take the lead here. It's now a 5-4 ball game.
Guy like this around the yard the way they've done so far. I mean, he came into this game with an ERA in the twos, but it's going to get up there after this shellac.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Belfre. As he's swinging first pitch and sends a line drive out to left center. And that's a base hit.
And when you see a guy rip one like this, one pitch after the previous guy left the yard, you know you're dealing with a pitcher whose mind is elsewhere. That'll snap you back to reality, though, pretty quick.
Well, now the Miami manager's up out of the dugout and on his way out to the mound. And we're going to see a pitching change, as that's going to do it for Jose Fernandez. Gone after 5 1/3 here, as he never really found his groove in this one. Mike Dunn will come on in relief now as he'll make his 35th appearance of the season. Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, as he'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. And that's through for a base hit.
A little bad luck there defensively. If that's hit at an infielder, a double play, but instead now you're in hot water here with one away.
Dominic Brown will step in now with three home in the inning and another two men out there on base.
This inning's really starting to unravel quickly from a defensive point of view. This is where you need a nice pop-up in a big way.
And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul, strike one. He's ready. Now the pitch. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away.
All right, make the count.
Comes set. Now the pitch. Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2.
I'll say this. He wasn't going to get his arms extended on that one.
And he might have another one as this is hit high and deep out to left. Into the seats, and it's gone. So a three-run blast to straightaway left, his second of the game, and they double him up. It's 8-4.
better feeling for a hitter after being backed off the plate than to turn around and do this on the next pitch. That is just the ultimate. You think you can intimidate me? Uh-uh. Think again.
First baseman number 6, Ryan Howard.
Here's big Ryan Howard now, as he will swing at the first pitch and send a ground ball out to short. A dive, but he can't get a glove on it. It's through for a base hit.
Well, they got him to hit it right into the shift, but even with 3 guys over there, they still couldn't get to this one. Just a little unlucky there.
Damian Trejo is out into the on-deck circle now, so that would appear to mean the end for Chad Billingsley. Wow, this ball's laced, and it's going to get down into the right center field gap. Howard being waved around third, heading for home. And the tag from Saltalamacchia, they got him at the plate.
Yeah, now in hindsight, you could have had runners at second and third with one out, but they roll the dice. They're trying to pick up that run for first, and it winds up not working out for them.
Here's Ben Revere, as he'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. Throw on to first will finally retire him as the inning will draw to a close. But not before they come up with 6 runs this half inning on the strength of a couple of home runs. 7th inning coming up. It's the Phillies 8 and the Marlins 4. Welcome back to Citizens Bank Park here in Philadelphia. It's on to the 7th inning now with the Phillies out in front, and it's a good time to check out our game summary through the first 6 innings so far. Ichiro Suzuki is up off the bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number 7. Aaron Harang is on the pitch now as he'll take over to start inning number 7.
Number 34, Aaron Harang.
And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball 1. Now, how important is it going to be for this guy to throw that curveball for strikes?
I don't know that he necessarily needs to ever throw it for a strike. I mean, if it's around the plate and he's getting guys to go after it, it's doing its job. But if he starts to get too high or too far outside, then it's just an easy take.
Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. The 2-2 coming. Goes the other way, and he got a lot of it out to deep left. And the move to the pinch hitter will not pan out as that's taken in for the first out.
And even with the new pitcher in there, I think you tip your cap a bit to that starter. I mean, he gutted out 6 tough innings, and he's given his guys a good chance at victory if this bullpen can hold the lead.
Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt the first pitch. And he'll look at a first-pitch curveball that's in the dirt. It's ball 1. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. Curveball hit on the ground to shortstop. And a throw over to Howard, and that's the second out. Martin Prado will dig in. Took a cold third strike his last time. Curveball taken outside to begin the at-bat. Ball 1. And the pitch. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. The 1-1. And that misses. 2-1. Pitch on the way. And he reaches out for one and may have chased it as this is skied into the air to straightaway center. Revere is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Miami down in order. They're unable to make a dent in an 8-4 deficit.
Your attention, please.
So a new pitcher set to come on. It'll be the 6-4 right-hander Nick Massett that gets the call. And a swing as he pulls this one into right. But this is right at him in right field as he hardly has to move to take it in for the first out.
First pitch swinging here to start the inning, and he didn't waste any time waiting for his pitch. He got it right there. Just hit it right at somebody.
Into the box, Brandon Jordan. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. One out, nobody on. Now here it comes. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. And this will stay inside the third base bag. A fair ball. The throw into second. And that is where the wheels pay off as he's able to make it into second with a hustle double.
Yeah. No hesitation there as we train our camera directly on him. Once this gets down the line, he's thinking two right out of the box, and he's able to beat the throw into second and leg out a double.
Michael Franco will stand in again as we flash you back to the middle innings here. This was a big blow, a two-run home run that really got his guys going. Now the first pitch. Breaking ball there as that's fouled away for the first strike.
Let's go one more time, baby.
He's set. Now the pitch. Into center field. That's going to get down for a base hit. Around third and being waved on home. And the runner will score from second.
That's his third RBI of the night, and he continues to swing the bat well.
Adrian Beltre will stand in with a run in, one out, and one on here in the inning. Now the first pitch, and a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Runner at first here, one man out. From the belt, kicks and deals. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. Here's the 1-1 now to Beltre. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now. Figure we'll probably see a heavy dose of that sinker here tonight.
It's really a pitch he'll lean on, especially when he needs that ground ball, but even in situations like this where he's just trying to get ahead.
Ah, had him fooled as he swings through the curveball. Two down.
You could pretty much follow the thought process here on swing track. He's getting ready for the fastball, 1-2, but they give him something off speed. He was way too early.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, as he will swing at the first pitch and send a ground ball out to short. On to the second baseman covering, and he can't handle it.
Well, he knows he's got a runner bearing down on him, so I'm not sure if he felt the footsteps or what, but boy, this throw is a good one. It just pops right in and out of the glove.
Dominic Brown will come forward now in an RBI opportunity he probably didn't think he'd have.
Yeah, it certainly didn't look like he'd have one, but now's where you really have to make teams pay. Nothing will demoralize a team in the field quite like having two out errors that lead to runs.
Too low, 1-0.
He knows he should be out of the inning already, but you know, he's got to pick up his defender behind him and get out of this.
The 1-0 home. Oh, hit sharply as this is pulled into right. And that's going to get down out there. Around third and being waved on hold. And the runner will score from second.
Yeah, he's already had a great game. RBIs are starting to add up now. That's his fifth run he's driven in so far. This time on an RBI double.
Here's big Ryan Howard now. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
Oh, man, if you're a pitching coach, you might want to update your resume after this performance. His guys have been brutal.
Now Howard waits on the 1-0. 1-1.
Oh, and he sure got a good one, doesn't he? That ball goes from about knee-high to ankle-high in the matter of about 5 feet.
Come on now, Billy.
1-1 on the way. There's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. A big pitch here, 1-2. Here's a swing and a chance now for the first baseman, Morse. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Another good inning here for the Phillies, and the brotherly love is in abundance now. Back with more on this fine Saturday night following this. Giancarlo Stanton will get us going now in the top half of the eighth. Good fastball there to start the at-bat as Harang jumps ahead, nothing and one.
Well, you can tell he's trying to work that pitch away, but he might have left that one a little more over the plate than he intended.
Here it comes. Way outside. 1-2. Now here's the pitch. And he reaches for one out of the zone and misses rather badly for the first out. Well, this has been a bullpen game for some time now, but let's go back and review the performances of the two starters, neither of whom turned in an outing to remember. Marcell Ozuna will get another crack, 1-for-3 thus far. And a tough slider there from Harang. No balls and a strike. Credit where credit's due. This guy's done a good job out of the bullpen.
No question. He's been able to hold that lead, and these guys really haven't threatened him at all.
Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1.
Yeah, and on 2-1 right now, you gotta figure this guy's wound up for the fastball here. Maybe you come with the breaking ball here out of the zone and hope he goes after it.
Swing and a line drive. Foul. Here's the 2-2 offering. And he struck him out. And there's the hat trick. And that's his third strikeout of the ballgame. Our line score to this point tells the story. You see the Phillies leading this one at home here at Citizens Bank Park as we draw nearer to the end. Michael Morse will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ballgame are growing dimmer by the batter.
Swinging a hard hit ball towards the hole. And that's in there, so perhaps some life here with two men out. Jared Saltalamacchia will step in. An RBI single this last time around. And that's in there for strike one. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. From the belt, the pitch. Swing, high drive, deep down the left field line. This ball is slicing out of here. So they narrow the gap, and hey, don't count these guys out just yet. So a two-run homer down the line in left. Home run number 5 on the year as they've cut this deficit down to 4.
Boy, and how this thing winds up being a home run is beyond me. Take a look at this. This is an off-speed pitch, and it's on the outer part of the plate. So if he hits this thing to center field, it's just going to be an easy routine fly ball. But instead, the ball hugs the line out there, and he manages to just have enough of it to clear the wall. Hey, they all count.
Donovan Solano stand in to keep things going, and I don't know, Steve, is the comeback on?
Well, at the very least, I like that they're showing some character out there. You never want to go down without a fight, so they're going to make these final at-bats count.
Curveball close, but it's 1-1. And now pitch on the way. High and wide, 2 balls and a strike. The ball flying around the yard in this one, as you see so far there. Called strike that time, and it's even at 2-2.
Now at the plate,
Here's,
and we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run home run. Bottom of the eighth coming up. It's the Phillies 10 and the Marlins 6. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Brian Morris is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth.
Batting in the sixth spot, number 57, Brian Morris. Now catching and batting in the ninth spot, number 6, Jeff Mathis.
Xavier Paul is going to get off the bench here as he'll hit for the pitcher Harang. Marlins have some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and throwing. And this ball is crushed deep down the right field line. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. Now the pitch. Now a big swing, and this is a major league pop-up way up there toward the center of the diamond. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one.
Sometimes when you're throwing 95 miles an hour, you can make a mistake and get away with it. Here, he just can't get on top of this one and winds up popping it up.
Now here's the first pitch. And this is lifted the other way to left center. Under it is Ozuna, and there are two gone now. Chase Utley will dig in. He lined out hard in his last time around. Now here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss, 0-1.
And even with two outs, this is a team that can still put something together here, especially in this part of the lineup, so you can't let your guard down.
This is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2. Now the pitch. And a bouncing ball, foul. Now another 0-2. And a good two-strike swing here as he's been fighting off some tough pitches, but the count will remain at 0-2. Another 0-2 coming. And look out as that one ran in and got him.
Well, with two outs and nobody on, the best way to make a team pay for hitting you is to come around and score. Let's see what they can do.
Brandon Jordan will step in. He doubled and later scored his last time. First pitch on the way. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. The 1-0. Look out, 2-0 now.
Don't expect him to forget throwing inside, even after the hit by pitch. You just won't start giving in to guys out there.
Now the 2-0 home. 3-0 now.
Do you wonder if hitting that last hitter may have rattled him a little? He's having an awfully hard time finding the strike zone now.
3-0 is on the way. And that's off his leg on the mound. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it. It looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. Michael Franco will stand in with a showdown looming. Two on, two out here in inning number 8. First pitch coming. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0.
Now he's going to have to punch his way off the ropes now.
On the way. And a drive out to deep right center field. And over the scoreboard, home run. So a three-run.
guys talking about pitches that hang. You know, they're talking about the curveball, maybe a slider. But this is a cut fastball. It just hangs. You see it there. Just right out over the heart of the plate. He doesn't miss it.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre. As he'll swing and lift a foul ball off to the left and out of play. Here's the pitch.
Here we go.
Oh, they think they may have gotten him again. This one's hit deep to left field. And for the second time in the inning, the Gopher ball will come back to bite it. It's a home run. So a solo home run off the bat of Adrian Beltre. Number 11 for him on the season as they've widened this lead to 8 now.
As a pitcher, and especially as a relief pitcher, you got to have a short memory out there. Here, he gets burned again on back-to-back home runs. Not really what you want to do when you're coming out of the pen.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez, as he will swing at the first pitch and send a ground ball out to short. And that'll get through into center field for a base hit.
And here's a case on the mound where he's trying to sneak a first-pitch fastball by him. But he was having none of that at the plate. He just sends it right back where it came from.
Here's the left-handed hitting Dominic Brown. And he goes the other way as this is hit high and deep out to straightaway left. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. So they nearly bat around here as 8 men come to the plate, and they push across 4 runs. 9th inning coming up. Phillies lead this one 14-6. Genmar Gomez will come in now working with a huge lead, so he'll just look to get some work in here. Adani Echevarria will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Here we go with inning number 9 as the first pitch misses for ball 1. A chance here at least for this guy to get some work in what should be a fairly low-stress appearance.
Yeah, but it seems like these outings are where you relax a little bit too much, you give up 3 runs, and then watch your ERA climb by another point. He'll need to guard against that.
And this will find the seats behind the first base dugout. He'll try again, 1-2. Hard hit down the line. And he'll reach to start the inning as this ball gets through him, a base hit.
And at this point, I don't think you could expect anything less than a 2-hit ball game from this guy. I mean, he's been as hot as anybody lately, and he comes through again here.
Utley for 1. Over to Howard, and indeed, they get them both.
Well, the one thing this guy definitely has coming in out of the bullpen is that hard sinking fastball. And here it is in all its glory as he gets the big double play ball to take away the pressure.
In is Christian Yelich. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball 1. 1-0. Fastball in there for a strike. 92 on the radar gun that time.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller out there, you're just conditioned to always look for something down. So he can surprise you with that high fastball, maybe four-seam it every once in a while. And when he does, you can forget it.
Taken called strike 2, and now they're down to their final strike tonight. Now a swing and a miss on a pitch to tie them up in knots, and the ball game is over.
And I think just about everybody wound up having a hand in this victory as they go on to win this one by 8 runs.
pretty much over before it started as we give you a final look at the line score here in what turned out to be a blowout victory.
But that's all right. He definitely did enough to earn himself the hardware.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Carroll, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com. The Phillies win this one 14-6. Good.